Welcome back to another episode of The Daily Beard, which has lately become very much, not daily, maybe we should call it the monthly beard. Let's talk today about how reading glasses make you dependent on reading glasses. And I have talked about this on a number of occasions, a number of videos, and a number of posts on the site linked below. Short version is this: presbyopia, meaning you can't read small text clearly up close anymore, to some degree. That's creeping in possibly in your 40s. The more you live in a space where it's strongly encouraged to visit doctors at all possible occasions, even optometrists who are not, in most places, medical doctors, you tend to be sold treatments, right? Like you're being sold pills, you're being sold things, and a lot of times the explanation is you're just getting old. I've had this because clearly I'm getting old. Trying to resist that a lot of times makes sense. Understanding the underlying what's up here a lot of times makes sense. Looking at addressing things with healthy lifestyle and diet a lot of times makes sense. Not always, right? There's genuine medical conditions, in which case I have no advice, but a lot of times it's just beware of people that are specialized in a specific topic, identifying an issue that they're trained to identify, even if it's possibly not a real issue for you. I'm not saying it's just possible. I see that a lot. People come in their 40s, go to an optometrist, a lens sales shop in a shopping mall, and are being told, hey, try these reading glasses. Here's what happens. The lens in the eye hardens with age to some degree. Like, I'm almost 50, I can read everything fine up close. Anecdotal, not science, yes. Hardens a little bit. Now, the ciliary muscle, the focusing muscle, shapes the lens for close-up vision. It squeezes the lens bulges. The closer you look at something, the harder, the more the lens gets squeezed, basically. As the lens becomes less flexible, malleable with age, you can't get it as close, as easily, as long. That's presbyopia, basically. In good lighting, you might not notice it. If the text is not tiny, you might not notice it. If you're not holding it really close to your face, you might not notice it. And therein lies some of the answers to preventing lens dependence for presbyopia. I'm not aware of a quote-unquote cure or a fix for presbyopia. I'm only aware of how do you prevent yourself from becoming dependent on lenses and being unable to read up close without them. And the simple answer is don't use them. Do not use reading glasses if you don't absolutely need them. You absolutely need them in a dark restaurant and a font is tiny and you just can't read it. And you're just going to be a silly person and feel old if you can't read the menu, right? That's one of those times, possibly, if that's the case, where you may have to pull out reading glasses. But reading a book, if you have the option to sit next to a naturally lit ambient environment, window style, and you can read it fine, do that instead of reading glasses. Why? Because you're making the ciliary muscle work to shape the lens, keeping the lens more flexible. This is the assumption, right? We haven't taken anybody's eye apart to check it, but that is a reasonable assumption based on how the biology works. Keep yourself in environments where you do not require the reading glasses. If you wear the reading glasses move the light in the eye and thereby making it not necessary for the focusing muscle to do any work or a lot less work. So the lens is not getting moved, thereby much more likely to harden, and the muscle is not being exercised. And those are all things you want to avoid, right? Just because you're walking is strenuous, you don't start riding a wheelchair. To a degree, right? Like if you're getting headaches, if it's uncomfortable, either maybe you need reading glasses, the lowest possible diopters, which means you don't necessarily trust the optometrist. These things are $10, right? Like the same as minus lenses are wholesale, $2 to $5. So let somebody make 50% profit. Say they're $10, buy a really nice pair for $20. A minus half diopter, right? Or plus in this case for reading glasses, plus half, plus a quarter, plus 75. See what the lowest numbers that you can get by, still making that muscle work, still shaping the lens when it is necessary, right? Because the problem is you might go to one of those retail lens sellers who act like they're doctors and try to call things prescriptions with which reading glasses positively or not. And they give you a plus 1.5. All of a sudden, all the close-up stuff is crystal clear, zero effort required. You feel like it's a revelation, but it's not. It's no more than morphine is a revelation for pain or sugar is a revelation for a short-term awesome fix for feeling great. It's not what your eyes need, right? It seems great because now the muscle doesn't have to work. so your body goes, ooh, this is pleasant. Not what you want. You want as little plus diopters as possible, only in cases where you absolutely need them, continually using eyes as intended. A lot of times the fix is natural daylight, right? A lot of times the fix is hold the book a tiny little bit further away. If you're already wearing reading glasses, my opinion is find out what the plus is and see if you need all that plus. I've had a fair amount of people wean themselves from plus lens use, even though it takes more time. And this is not our topic, right? Our topic mainly is myopia. I'm just covering this because we have a significant population of people that are in that age range and that wear reading glasses. Reduce your dependence on them very gradually, right? A quarter diopter lower every 6 months, not immediately putting them on all the time. Mainly though, the diopter reduction. If you're at a plus two, for example, which sadly happens a lot, plus 1.75, right? Wear those. And then eventually switch to plus 1.5 and then switch to plus 1.25, very gradually. The goal is, you know, 5 years from now, you barely use them and they're very low diopters. That's my general recommendation. Hope you find this helpful. If you do, feel free to leave comments. I try to read comments. Comment quality has gotten a lot better recently. So I read more comments, feedback, questions, stuff that you want. Just let me know. See you in the next one. Meow, 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 meow.